Show me the side streets in your life.
Hey Northwood, welcome to NTV and what will be our last show for 2013.
Aw, so sad. Well, to all of you juniors and seniors out there who are interested in meeting with our state's lawmakers and their staff in order to lobby on behalf of our district, applications for the Sacramento trip are now being accepted.
Applications must be turned in to Ms. Roach by January 10th, and this is a really great chance for those of you who are interested in making a real positive impact on our school and our district.
Seniors, we are just 194 short days away from graduation. Hopefully you've already gotten your caps and gowns. However, if you've not done that yet, you will need to do it today on campus, or from now on you will have to go directly through the Jostin website.
And as always, make sure you get your grad night tickets. Over 50% of the seniors have already purchased theirs, so you definitely don't want to be left out.
Forms are in your TAs, and now we hand you over to Karen Yang with your NTV Life.
Good morning, Timberwolves. Welcome to the final show of 2013. Listen up to my final round of announcements for you guys. So on Monday, we've got one vocal concert just for you. Then on Tuesday and Wednesday, we've got two instrumental concerts also just for you. Then on Thursday, we've got our very special Winter Gala concert. It's like one of the best shows of the year, so you should definitely go check it out. If you're interested in any of these shows, go buy your Student Rush tickets. They're only $2 with your ID. Next up, here's a little feature about Tiffany Liu, one of our very own musicians.
My name is Tiffany Liu, and I go to Northwood High School. I've been playing piano for almost 10 years. When I perform, I'm definitely expressing a lot of my emotions, and music is a form of storytelling. My parents always tell me that, you know, no matter what, they'll always be there for me, and they really enjoy listening to me, and so I love, you know, hearing their praise.
I think she's just being very lucky that, you know, winning almost over 40 competitions. I wanted her just to enjoy music as part of her life.
Also, this summer I performed in Austria, which was a huge achievement and it was very exciting for me. I performed at the Esterházy Palace in Eisenstadt. It was surreal. It was really exciting for me, and it was a very beautiful hall with lots of paintings, you know, on the ceilings, and it was a very, very amazing experience.
We supported her by providing her the best equipment there is, and many resources like the music, the books, etc.
Well, one time in sixth grade, I had a very serious competition that I was actually very well prepared for. But towards the end, like right before the competition occurred, I was kind of slacking on my practice, and unfortunately that resulted in a mishap during the performance. So I did not win the competition, and that was almost like a breaking point. Like, should I continue or should I not if I'm gonna keep up, you know, that habit? My relationship with my teacher is very good. I think we have a very strong bond and we have a lot of fun together.
Right now I am her teacher.
My piano teacher is my mom.
When I try to be really focused to help her, sometimes, you know, my comments might taken beyond just a normal teacher's comments, you know.
It has both the pros and the cons, because sometimes, like, we get into arguments. I think it's, we take it personally.
Whether she's going for music as a major, really it's up to her. And, you know, she can pick any career she wants, and I'll be just as, you know, supportive and happy for her. Music is just part of life, yeah.
So to everyone who's in Spanish, a quick reminder that ticket signups for Spanish movie night are going down December 19th. is a Thursday, so head over to room 1229 to sign up. Also, another reminder, the canned food fundraising competition has been extended to Tuesday, not Friday, so bring in all your cans. My final announcement is to Mock Trial. Congratulations to all of you guys for a great, great run. They made it to the semifinals on the county level, and I am so proud of you guys. You guys do such great work. Anyways, that wraps it up for NTV Life this time. So before you go have fun with Feline and Jacob, I am saying goodbye to you. I will see you next year.
Christmas, and when you walk down the street, say hello.
What's up, TWF Nation? Welcome to another episode of NTV Sports. Our word of the day is poised.
Jacob, winter sports are my favorite time of the year.
Really, Feline? Why is that?
Because I'm a winter sports athlete.
You play sports?
Yeah. How else do you think I'm qualified to host this segment of NTV?
Well, what about me?
Like I said, I'm qualified.
Look, Feline, pick up basketball at the gym provides me with all the qualification I need to talk about overhyping athletics.
Speaking of boys basketball, tonight in the gym at 7 o'clock, our boys are having a big game and are in need of all Northwood to come out and support.
Oh yes, it's all the fun of Friday night football without the cold weather and less room for streakers to get away from our speedy counselors.
Our boys are currently 3-2 after beating Rancho Alamitos on Wednesday and are poised to destroy San Clemente, so make sure to come out tonight.
Moving on to soccer news, our girls' team is 0-2, but is looking to have a stellar season come league.
Girls' soccer!
Feline, what was that?
That was me giving a shout-out to girls' soccer.
Okay. In male soccer news, my good friend and Leicester TV host Evan Swartfigure has been proclaimed by the mighty legislative body known as Student Forum as Athlete of the Month. But in all seriousness, congratulations, Evan, you really deserve it.
Boys' soccer is currently sitting 2-1 and is poised for a great season.
Thank you, Girls Waterfall, for finally posting their scores on OC Varsity this past week. Our lovely ladies are 2-4 and heading into league play.
Hey, Jacob, I was wondering, didn't you and Evan have some sort of mustache-growing competition?
What?
Yeah, it's all coming back to me with you shaving his face and all this weird stuff.
No. I mean, we get together to shave our faces all the time, but nothing ever came of that competition. It was all for TV.
That's not what I heard.
Hello, Northwood, and welcome to the first annual NTV Mustache Competition. Let's go check in with our contestants. Jacob, let's see how you've held up through these past few weeks.
In New York, so you finally decided to grow your first beard. Congratulations, it's quite a journey. I had to learn a lot in the process, so I thought, you are your own worst critic. When you're growing your beard out, stop obsessing in front of mirrors. You want to make sure it looks nice, you don't want to look awful.
I can do this.
Hey. Hey. I thought you were participating in No Shave November.
Wait, well, I haven't shaved all month, Jake.
Evan, this has been a rough month for you. Let's go take a look.
Ew! His mustache looks gross!
They must have been talking about you.
So, Evan, what brings you in today?
What if I've gone too far already? What if there's nothing left?
Son, there's a lot left.
I think at this point in time, the best bet, no beard.
Evan. You've been disqualified due to mental health reasons.
Fine.
So that means the winner is... no one.
What?
Jacob, you've tested positive for Rogaine use.
What do you mean? I won this competition
fair. Hey, sir,
you
need to calm down.
Get away from me. Stop it!
Well, Northwood, that concludes our first and probably last NTV mustache competition.
Wow, don't even talk to me right now.
Whatever. They'll just suspend me for 90 games and I'll continue to make millions of dollars while still taking steroids. That's right, Major League Baseball, your drug enforcement program is a joke.
What?
Don't worry about it. Anyways, that's all we have time for this week, and thanks for tuning in. We'll see you after the new year.
Make sure to come out tonight at 7 to the gym.
Wait, Feline, before we go, why don't you tell everybody your New Year's resolution?
Well, my New Year's resolution is to stop being madly in love with this super cute guy I anchor with on NTV. Oh.
Okay. Well, my resolution is to bring peace to the Middle East. I hope to be as successful as I was in 2012, when my resolution was to re-elect President Obama.
Well, with that, happy holidays, NHS, and back to you, Evan and Nicole.
Whoa, I had no idea the mustache thing affected you that much.
Yeah, it was a rough month. My girlfriend wouldn't even get within 5 feet of me.
You have a girlfriend?
Yeah, we've been together like a year now. We even have our own Instagram.
Okay, that's a little too much.
Whatever. Juniors, important date alert. Mark your calendars. January 15th will be Junior Parent Night.
Our school's wonderful counselors will be assisting both students and parents to find out more information about the college application process.
You will learn such essential skills like making your extracurricular activities seem more important than they actually are, and how to scour your family records to find that 1/16th Native American that you know is in there somewhere.
Important skills, for sure.
And on January 4th, 2014, Northwood will be hosting the huge Orange County Film Festival. NTV would like to invite you to join us for this incredible event here in our very own Performing Arts Theater.
It includes entries from over 13 different high schools. Here's a time lapse of a recent film festival. The film festival will be held on January 4th at Northwood, so bring a date and enjoy the festivities.
I know I will.
Next week will be Holiday Spirit Week. Tuesday is Winter Whiteout. Wednesday is Hat and Scarf Day with free hot chocolate provided by ASB before school.
Thursday is Pajama Day, and Friday will be Ugly Sweater Day. Well, Northwood, we hope you can all survive just one more week, and we'll have a great winter break. Hit the slopes. Hang out with that special someone. Or just enjoy some downtime with friends.
Whatever it is that you end up doing, from all of us here at NTV, happy holidays and have a safe winter break.